Eugenia Cooney and Shane Dawson have reportedly been friends for some time now. They've also been in the news a lot lately as well. Eugenia's been getting heat from fans lately as they believe she's relapsed after coming back from rehab for an eating disorder. And Shane, well, I'm sure you're all familiar with why he's in the hot seat. But what about their time together? Their friendship? Their bond? Well, that's what we're exploring today, my friends. Let's look into the tea surrounding their friendship. What's going on, guys? I'm your host, Bri Room, and welcome back to IO. Before we dive into the video, just a little reminder to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you know when we've got some more hot tea coming your way. Also, don't forget that we have playlists for you to watch for more content like this, and stick around until the end because I'll be reading out some more of your comments. So in the timeline of Shane and Eugenia's friendship, we first see them together back in 2016 when Eugenia came in as a guest on Shane's podcast, Shane and Friends. In the episode, they really just had casual conversation about Eugenia's interests, and they really just got to know each other. The episode came out right at the start of Eugenia receiving hate for her suspected eating disorder, so this podcast heightened her popularity by introducing her to Shane's wider audience. Whether this new jump in popularity following the interview really did anything good for her image is debatable, but the bottom line here is that they began a friendship. Just prior to this, Shane had released a video talking about his eating disorder and body dysmorphia, so I'm guessing that Shane saw that sort of connection between the two of them and became an ally to her because of their shared experiences. The two weren't really seen together again until Shane released his documentary about Eugenia's eating disorder and time in rehab back in the summer of 2019. In the video, Shane spoke out about how he reached out to Eugenia during her treatment because he felt as though her journey needed to be shared in order to maybe help someone else who may be dealing with similar issues. Together, he and Eugenia created an hour-long video discussing eating disorders and their struggles with mental health and such. They seemed to have a good bond in the video, but also off camera, as Shane was seen encouraging Eugenia online for weeks after the release of the documentary. In the past, Shane had talked about his love for making his coveted YouTube documentaries because he wants to help people. Similarly, Shane made a docu-series covering YouTuber Bunny Mayer and her struggles on the platform. It seemed like with Eugenia, he was looking to uplift her on the platform, especially coming from receiving so much hate for her appearance just prior to going to rehab. After the documentary was released, Shane and Eugenia filmed a video together for Eugenia's channel where they discussed all the things that Eugenia missed out on when she was in rehab. In the lighthearted video, the pair discussed pop culture events from the past few months, brainstormed ideas for Eugenia's channel since she had returned, and really just had fun and laughed in the video. It was like watching two friends chilling out and having a conversation, and their friendship seemed pretty genuine. The two haven't really been seen together since then, though they've had interactions with each other online, and Shane sent Eugenia a PR package with his Jeffree Star Cosmetics collection. Now, in light of the recent backlash towards Shane, some of his friends have come to defend him to tell their side of who they believe Shane to be. YouTubers such as Trisha Paytas, Brittany Louise Taylor, as well as Eugenia Cooney have pleaded to fans to be patient with Shane and to judge him based on his current actions rather than his past. Eugenia shared her thoughts on the situation by replying to a tweet that Trisha sent out about Shane, saying, "I agree with everything you say so much. This kind of hate is too much for anyone to handle, and I wish people would think about it if it was them getting hated on and how they might feel. No one deserves to be treated like that." As of right now, Shane isn't very active online, and Eugenia is beginning to receive hate for her appearance once again, but judging by how they've come to each other's aid before, I'm sure they're helping each other out behind the scenes. Okay guys, before I end the video, let's go ahead and read some of your comments from last week's weekly news roundup. Michelle Vo says, "Kinda happy Keeping Up with the Kardashians it's ending, but sad I can't see Kourtney slap Kim again." Oh, that was a good time. I'm actually so sad that it's ending. I didn't watch like every episode, but all of the episodes were just so good. So leave me a comment down there telling me, you know, which moment was your favorite, because there were so many good ones. My favorites probably have to be anything that Scott Disick says, because he's like salty all the time, but like sassy, it's great. Anthony Armento says, "I love how all the hosts of IO come together for the roundup. It's great." It is great. It's so much fun to film. I love my IO family. Layla Mathias says, "Everyone is getting canceled slash dragged. I hope 2021 isn't all about the cancel culture." You know what? It's too soon to tell. Maybe the Mayans were wrong, and instead of 2012 being the end, it was 2021 and we're all screwed. I don't know. I wish everyone the best. And with that, I'll end the video here. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did and want to see more content like this, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more IO content. I will catch you guys in the next one, so TTFN, my dudes. Eugenia has been getting heat from fans lately. As they believe she's relapsed and... As they believe she's relapsed... Ha ha. It was like watching two friends chilling out and having a conversation. Ugh. It was like watching two friends chilling out and having a conversation. Okay guys, now before I end the video, let's go ahead and read some of your comments from last week's weekly tongue twister.